What's everybody? Tyson Roush. Let's Talk Mental Health, episode number 31. If you're watching this on our Jets channel, just go Let's Talk Mental Health on YouTube. Subscribe. We would definitely appreciate it. I'm TRoush21 on Twitter, TRoush2121 on Instagram. If you ever want to reach out and send me a message, completely cool with that. I hope everybody is well. It's been a little while, so we've done a video. Crazy times. Been trying to get some sun, as you see. I've got some sunburn. But, you know, it's just this past week I watched a show. Sully Erna of Godsmack has the SCARS Foundation, which is a foundation all about mental health, suicide prevention, anxiety, depression, bullying, all that. And he had some fascinating guests. The lead singer of Pretty Reckless shared some stories about when, you know, we recently, you know, the anniversary of the passing of Chester Bennington and Chris Cornell came up, which is a very sad time, but it impacted so many people in so many different ways. And for her, it impacted her tour. They had to cancel the tour. So, you know, here's this, you know, band on the rise, their big debut, their big opportunity. This sets things off. It's not something you can recover from very easily. Then now, fast forward, they have a hit record. They have their song now, I think it's called The Death of Rock and Roll, or whatever it is. Number one song in the world, of the country, big number one rock song, and they can't even perform it. So it sets you down like different ways where you don't feel, you know, you're going to your dark place. You can't play with your band. You can't do certain things. Then like Brent Smith and Shinedown came on, talking about the struggles they have where you're usually always around your bandmates or doing all these things. Half your band's in quarantine. You can't do certain things. And it was fascinating to hear all their stories and how they're trying to handle things, you know, and you just see that the struggle is real. Like everybody has their own personal issues and their own ways of handling it. Like my parents are, you know, older and they're used to always being out and about. They're very independent, you know, going to Atlantic City in New Jersey or going to restaurants, doing all this stuff. And all that's been taken away from them. So now they're basically, they're limited to going, you know, in their backyard barbecuing, they'll go fishing, they do little things, but they're getting, you know, they're starting to get to them now where they're starting to crack a little bit and they're starting to get irritable and they're getting antsy and they can't do anything because they can't risk their health. They're both high risk and it's not easy, but now you're starting to see the mental fatigue. You see that with a lot of people, like, you know, a lot of people, like business owners are struggling, whether you own a gym or if you have restaurants, but you're not making money, like the financial strain, the anxiety about the health, all these things is starting to get to everybody. And it's serious. It's a serious, serious issue. Nobody really talks about it, and I'm not really sure why. It should be a much bigger story than it is. And now it's a matter of how do we all handle it? Like, how do you do it? Like, I try to find ways to give my parents things to do. I stop by and talk to them. And that's kind of, to me, is the biggest thing is, you know, as a society, all of us, we need to reach out to each other. And if you haven't talked to somebody in a while, reach out and say, hey, I mean, right now we could text. We text all day long. Send a text. How you doing, man? How you know? Or it's a female. How you doing? Whatever. It's just reach out and say hello, check in, offer a, hey, let me stop by and we'll have a sandwich in the yard, whatever it is. But we got to be there for each other because there's so many people struggling. And a lot of people are hiding it. The suicide rates are not being talked about enough in this world, but they should be because people are struggling and they're on the brink. And if you watch the news or you watch social media sometimes, it can push you over the edge. And that's why there's times where I recommend just, you know what? Take your phone and turn it off and just go for a long walk or go to the beach or do whatever you can to just escape the madness for a little while. Like find your own personal time to just regroup and get your sanity back. Like I'll do it. Like I'll go for a run and I just put my music on and I'm gone. Hour and a half. And I'm just trying to refocus and just get back, just regroup. You know, and you have to. But you got to find some ways to just keep yourself even keel. You know, and if it's not running, you'll find whatever it is, play music or checkers, play games, play an instrument, go whatever little thing it is you enjoy. But it's got to be something you truly enjoy. You can't be something you're forced to do. When you're forced to do something, it's never going to last. You got to find something where you get personal satisfaction and personal happiness out of. Could be reading a book, could be watching a Netflix series, it could be anything. So the first thing is be sure you reach out to everybody around you. And the one thing is too, is when I'm kind of down and out and I'm not feeling good, I'll reach out to my friends because I know I need human interaction. Or I need like a voice of reason, or I need just a conversation to just kind of crack my spell there where I'm like, hey, you know what, this isn't going the right way. Or, you know, and so if that's your own personal thing, for other people, especially people that live alone, like, you know, I'm a single guy, I live by myself. So it's like, dude, there are times where you're like, god damn, can't really go out. Most, you know, everybody's kind of quarantining, or not quarantining, but kind of like staying in, not really a lot going on. It's just like, you sit there and you're just like, what is this world coming to? Like, when is this going to end? And you start doubting things and worrying about things. So then I'll start working on a podcast. I'll work, you know, do whatever little things. But you got to recognize when those situations are you know, kind of overcoming you or taking over. You're starting to feel yourself going the wrong way or just kind of getting down and out, and limit it. Like, you know, you can have it. You don't make 1 hour become a day, and a day become 3 days, 3 days become a week. You kind of try to find where it's like, listen, I'm having a bad day. Shit's not good, but we're going to snap out of it and we're going to find a way to be better. So you got to worry about yourself. Got to worry about others. Reach out to others and just try to find things to, you know, just stay positive about. You know, it's very easy to get caught up in a lot of negativity, especially if you watch the news where almost every story is negative. You see this in sports too. Like if a guy goes out in the community, gives out 300 turkeys and signs 5,000 autographs, nobody talks about it. The guy goes out in the street and punches somebody in the face, that's the biggest news. So sometimes you got to just find other things to focus on and work on just being positive and embracing it and say, listen, you know what? Better days are ahead. You know, if you're, you know, this, we're not going to be in this current pandemic forever. There are going to be other days. And I think what we all got to understand is we have to adjust and adapt. Well, obviously we all want to be back watching football games, going to football games or going to concerts or being out, you know, indoor dining, hanging out with friends in restaurants and bars and whatever else. But if it doesn't happen, let's find things that we can do in the interim, whether it is having barbecues, whether it is, you know, finding other things we can do. Like, you know, there's a lot of creative people out there doing things where they're doing drive-in concerts. There are some sporting events that you can attend, like, you know, like outdoor events you can attend. Like a lot of the minor league baseball parks are doing things, they're doing fireworks, or they're doing limited crowds, like 250 people to see, you know, a comic, like a comedian, things like that. You just got to adjust it. Like, listen, it's not the way it used to be, but we can find ways to make things better until then, until we get back to the way it used to be. You know, or if there's a new normal, which everybody likes to say, then let's find out what that's going to be and find ways to embrace that. So, kind of like a long video, I guess, but just want to check in, everybody. Better days are always ahead, and just try to stay positive and try to recognize when things aren't going well and try to find out, you know, identify it and reach out and get help. The most important thing out of all this is to recognize that you're not alone, and you're not. I mean, I just watched this video where you saw five major, major players in the rock industry all talk about their mental health struggles. All of them talked about it. There's players. There's many NFL players that are openly talking about it. Hockey players, celebrities, everybody's talking about it. So you're not alone, and there's always a way to get out of the funk, whether it's calling somebody, texting somebody, sending an email, going on an online chat, finding ways to just get yourself out of the funk as fast as humanly possible. Now, it's not always easy. I admit it. There's times where I know it and I just can't get out of it, but you got to find it and you got to recognize it. And then hey, it could just be calling a friend and be blatant about it. Listen, man, I am struggling. I am depressed as hell. I'm anxious as hell. And I don't know how to change my mindset and get that help that you need. You know, and it's not, help doesn't need to be, I mean, help can be therapy, but help could just be a conversation just to reset your mind. So that's kind of it. I'm going to try to do more videos. Just been super, super busy with work and everything else. So stay positive, stay healthy, stay active, stay in touch with everybody else. Do not isolate yourself and reach out to those around you, family, friends. You never know if somebody's struggling, and it's just, you never know how a text message or a simple hello can go such a long way for other people. So have a good day, and I'll talk to you next time.